So I'm going to hand it over to you to close it out, but
all right.
I'll have you answer a question that I've been thinking about lately.
Okay.
Where do you draw the line between necessity and luxury when it comes to drumming?
Necessity and luxury. So, well, obviously studio stuff comes to mind, right? Because you and I have talked a lot about different gear purchases in here, or even questions about like, why did I buy this and what does it do? And you helped set up a lot of this studio when we first moved in here. I think one important thing, really, so necessity could go either direction, right? Because I deal with this with people that write in with gear questions, and they'll say, should I get the 8-channel Scarlett interface, or should I get the 8-channel Claret interface? And the reality is, they're both fine. They're both totally fine, but it depends on what your desired outcome is. So for me, the line between necessity and luxury is oftentimes relevant to what is the goal. Because if you said, you know, I want to be able to record some Instagram videos, maybe cut a drum cover for my YouTube channel, and I'd like to do some basic scratch recordings for this band, this project that I'm in. In that case, you know, what you necessarily need is not luxurious pieces of gear. You don't need high-end Earthworks microphones. You don't need an AKG C414 for your overheads. If ultimately you're just creating some drum covers, you might just need a GoPro, and you might need the, you know, like a basic pack of Shure microphones and the cheaper option for an interface, maybe just the live mixer. So in a case like that, what you necessarily need is not that expensive. It's not that outrageous. And in your case, you know, buying the Claret, buying the Earthworks microphones, buying that nicer camera lens, that would all be defined as luxurious. It's above and beyond what you actually need. But conversely, if you said, I want to run a recording studio that is competitive in my city, I want to be a destination for bands to come to me and have a professionally mixed album, I want to be able to cut, let's say, high-end music videos that can compete with other videographers in my area, or I want to be very competitive in the YouTube space, whether it's drums or any other type of sector you could think of. You know, if that's what you're going for, then all of a sudden, that $600 camera lens, the $2,000 in microphones, the $1,200 interface, all of a sudden, that's not luxurious anymore. It is a necessity, because this is your whole world. This is what you want to do, and this is the market that you want to compete within. So for me, you know, I look around my studio, and I do have expensive gear that I put my life savings into. But I don't define it as luxurious necessarily, because this is what I do for a living. And if my goals changed, you know, the goalposts kind of move for the gear itself, right? Like this would all be considered hyper luxurious if this was just my hobby. But it's not. It's very much what I do for a living. So for me, it is very important that I have high-end professional gear. With that said, I'm not running Apogee Duets and Neumann microphones and using a Rupert Neve board, you know, or a baby SSL, right? I mean, there's levels to this game for sure. But I think a lot of times when you think about spending in the long term $10,000 or $20,000 in gear, you know, yes, you can call that luxurious for a hobbyist. It certainly would be. But that's not the case if your goal is to operate and compete in a space where everybody has to have that level of gear, because that's the quality of content that you want to actually put out. So maybe that's a good thought experiment for the week is, you know, if you're looking into new gear, which let's be honest, all musicians and all drummers seem to constantly be looking for new gear, even if we don't need it. But I guess ask yourself, where do you want this to go, right? If your long-term goal is ultimately just to create, let's say, content for personal enjoyment, or have a studio that caters just to your hobby, right? If that's how you define all of this, then yeah, you can draw some of those lines a little bit earlier and say, maybe I don't have to spend that much money. Maybe I'd be happy with some sort of more fundamental setup. But if that's not the case, if you want to be competitive and really like hang with the big dogs in the recording world, they have spent some money on recording gear, and you get what you pay for a lot of times. So yeah, I think that's how I would draw that line between necessity and luxury. Just comes down to what is your desired outcome here, and what level of gear do you need to reach that desired outcome? Does that kind of make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you for watching this clip of the Orlando Drummer Podcast. I hope you enjoyed it. If you're looking for more content like this, consider yourself formally invited to come join me on OrlandoDrummer.com. It's an online drum school, very much in the style of Netflix. There's over 160 hours of content waiting for you there. You can try it free for 7 days at the link in the description. I'll see you guys there.